Two more technical details about Word2Vec and about methods to learn embeddings in general. First, because of the way embeddings are trained, it's often better to measure the closeness using a cosine distance instead of L2, for example. That's because the length of the embedding vector is not relevant to the classification. In fact, it's often better to normalize all embedding vectors to simply have unit norm. Second, we have the issue of trying to predict words, and there are lots of them. So in Word2Vec, we have this setup. We have a word that we're going to embed into a small vector, then feed that into a simple linear model with weights and biases, and that outputs a softmax probability. This is then compared to the target, which is another word in the context of the input word. The problem, of course, is that there might be many, many words in our vocabulary, and computing the softmax function over all those words can be very inefficient. But you can use a trick. Instead of training the softmax as if the label had probability 1 and every other word had probability 0, you can sample the words that are not the target, pick only a handful of them, and act as if the other words were not there. This idea of sampling the negative targets for each example is often called sampled softmax, and it makes things faster at no cost in performance. That's all there is to it. You take your large corpus of text, look at each word, embed it, and predict its neighbors. What you get out of that is a mapping from words to vectors where similar words are going to be close to each other.